What's up, soldiers? My name is Craig FPS, the Zombies Extraordinaire, and welcome back to another video here today on my channel. What I got for you guys in this video is a rank from the worst zombies map all the way to the best zombies map, in my personal opinion. Usually when I make top 10s, it's your votes, but this one is completely my opinion. So if you guys disagree with me, I'm already expecting it, all right? You can comment down below your top 5 favorite maps, or you can comment all 21 and rank your own zombies map down in the comment section. Whatever you guys want to do, but trust me, you're gonna get triggered. So now that we got that out of the way, let's get right into the number 21 spot. Coming in at the 21 spot is going to be Verrockt. Now, this map is not my cup of tea at all. Probably one of the most difficult maps ever in Zombies, and it's only the second map that ever came out, so it's really bland, but what do you expect from World at War? Coming in at the number 20 spot is Shinonuma. The only good thing that map had was the Wunderwaffe and the Flogger. Coming in at the number 19 spot is the first map ever in Zombies. Although they introduced it 4 freaking times, it's still not my favorite map and I don't really like it that much. I still don't understand why they had to put it in Transit. That just made that map worse. Coming in at the number 18 spot is going to be Nuketown. Now, normally it's a multiplayer map and it's good for multiplayer, but leave it in multiplayer. It's just not good for Zombies. Really boring map. I mean, it was fun for survival and if you wanted to, you know, wish you died multiple times when you get the war machine, but other than that, it's not really that special. Coming in at the number 17 spot is Transit, and that's because the denizens, the fog, the lava, having to open pack-a-punch, it's just a bad map. You guys know I don't like Transit. 17 though out of 21, that's actually pretty good comparatively, because you'd think I'd like Shinonuma more than that, but nope. Coming in at the number 16 spot is going to be Dyrise. Now, this map is pretty fun when you have the liquefier or you're doing the Easter egg and things like that. But other than that, the map is really, really bad just because of how you have to traverse the map, jumping from story to story, building to building, falling off the map, wanting to kill yourself multiple times, maybe game. It's just not that fun. Coming in at the number 15 spot is going to be Zetsubo no Shima. Now, this map is actually not that bad. I really do enjoy playing the Easter egg, playing the map in general, but it just didn't, you know, go as high as some of the other maps that I really, really did enjoy. So that's why it's kind of gotten a mid-range rank. It's not the worst map in Zombies, but it's definitely not the best. Coming in at the number 14 spot is going to be Revelations. Now, Revelations is fun for the Thunder Gun and having the Apothecary Servant upgrade and all that awesome stuff. The Easter egg is really fun, except for when you have to freaking shoot rocks, which is the dumbest step ever in Zombies ever for an Easter egg. Like, I would rather play Infinite Warfare Zombies or Exo Zombies and do an Easter egg on Burger Town than play that, or Infection is what the real name is. So, Revelations got the number 14 spot. And once again, it's kind of a mid-range map, not the best, not the worst, you know, that's just how it is. Coming in at the number 13 spot is going to be 5. Now, 5 is one of my favorite maps because of the location. It's such a diverse map. It's so unique. We have the Pentagon Thief. It's in the Pentagon. It's a little bit challenging. It's really tight and close quarters. There's the first buildable item ever in that map where you have to get the switch for the electric trap and you have to build it upstairs in the security systems that people walk through. So that's really cool. And I think this map just gets like a ton of hate, but it's honestly one of my favorite. And that's why it's starting to get into my favorite map. Coming in at the number 12 spot is going to be Moon. Now, I really do like this map for the Easter egg and the storyline implications that it did have at the end of Black Ops 1 leading into Transit. Now, obviously, I don't like Transit very much because I've already talked about it, but at the same time, Moon introduced a lot of really cool things. We got the brand new Wonder Weapon, the Wave Gun, which is really cool when you take them apart. It's the Zap Guns. Really, really cool concept, playing on the Moon as well with the different gravity levels and things like that. So that map was definitely very, very diverse. And then going to Area 51, starting out on Earth at Groom Lake, a really, really cool concept. So that map was a lot of fun, but it got the number 12 spot for me. Coming in at the number 11 spot, it's going to be Kino Daratoan. Now, this map was originally supposed to be in World at War, so I don't really think it's my favorite map by any means. It's really, really bare bones, and the only perk they ended up adding to it besides the original 4 was Mule Kick. Now, I'm happy they brought it back into Black Ops 3 because it is fun to play from time to time, and even nowadays, I'll still go back on Xbox and play Kino with randoms because I find it enjoyable, but at the same time, it's not one of my favorite maps. It's just kind of one of those maps that is easy to play, easy to train, all that stuff. So it's kind of just a beginner's map, but it's still fun to play from time to time. Coming in at the number 10 spot is going to be Darius or the Giant. Now, this map is really, really fun to play if you're just trying to chill and have a good time and like talk with friends and things like that, or if you just want to level up in zombies. That's what a lot of people did when Black Ops 3 came out, just to level up. We would just go on the Giant, play, and have some fun. Now, this map is fun just for the sole fact that it's bare bones. You don't really have to do much besides link the teleporters, then you can pack a punch and have yourself a good time. You can train, you can turn on electric traps, you can camp, do whatever you want. So that's why I brought Darius or the Giant to the number 10 spot. Coming in at the number 9 spot is going to be Shangri-La. Now, I really do enjoy this map a lot. The 3179 JGB215 is my favorite wonder weapon, and I'm so happy they brought it into Zombies Chronicles. Being able to do the Easter egg again, one of the coolest Easter eggs. The Easter egg's really fun. It's pretty challenging. The map is close quarters, which makes it more difficult. And I love difficult maps because it really separates the noobs from the pros. And I'm still in the middle of that. But at the same time, I think that this map is really fun because it challenges me to be a better zombies player, and it challenges everyone else in the community as well. Coming in at the number 8 spot is going to be Call of the Dead. Now, you might not expect this to be one of my favorite maps, but it actually is. I think that this is by far one of the most unique maps that we ever got in zombies. Having George chase you around is pretty annoying with stage lights and slam you, but at the same time, it had PhD Flopper, which was a lot of fun. The Easter egg is really cool, where all the characters are stuck behind a locked, like, metal safe type looking thing, and it's just a really, really unique experience playing that map, and it's a lot of fun. So I think that overall that map is awesome. The scavenger is a great wonder weapon. The VR-11 is pretty trash and if you're playing solo, but it's okay in co-op because it literally makes your teammates invincible for a little bit. But other than that, I think Call of the Dead definitely deserved the number 8 spot on my list. Coming in at the number 7 spot is going to be Ascension. Now, this is another map that I really do enjoy just because of how simple it is. This is another map that I can just jump on, have a good time, train, get the Thunder Gun, have some fun, and also there's a small Easter egg, the first actual Easter egg quest in Zombies, so it's definitely a really, really fun map, but the monkeys really do piss me off, so that's only the downside of the map. Other than that, it's a fantastic map and really, really fun to play, and also the, you know, experience of being in Russia is really, really cool. Coming in at the number 6 spot is going to be Buried. Now, Buried is one of my favorite maps, and it's not because it's simple. It's because I love the Easter egg. The Easter egg is so, so fun, and also the weapons that you can get from the box, the cool things you can do with Leroy. It's just a great, great map, and I love playing it from time to time as well. I'll still hop on, camp at Jug if I want, or I can train, do whatever I really want on Buried, and just have a ton of fun getting the paralyzer, being able to fly over the doors in the hedge area, or, you know, camping at Pack-a-Punch, or jumping over barriers. It's just a ton of fun. I really do enjoy that map, and the fact that it had the bank made it so much easier, but the Easter egg is a lot of fun, and I really still enjoy it a ton to this day. By far, one of my favorite Easter eggs ever in Zombies. Coming in at the number 5 spot is a Black Ops 3 classic, Garad Krovi. Now, this map introduced so many awesome things into Zombies, and it is by far one of the coolest maps ever. Now, being able to fly on dragons, the Easter egg was a challenge, the Nikolai boss fight, the bomb step elusively was kind of annoying, but other than that, the map was so cool. The just awe feeling of being in World War II Stalingrad, really, really awesome. And I just loved it a lot. So definitely Garad Krovi deserved the number 5 spot. Coming in at the number 4 spot is going to be Shadows of Evil. Now, Shadows of Evil introduced a bunch of awesome stuff into zombies. We got the Marguas, which were not the best, or the Parasites, to be honest. But we also got, like, a jump scare Easter egg. We got how to get a free Gobblegum. You could do that. You could upgrade the freaking trip mines. I mean, there was so many cool Easter eggs hidden within Shadows, as well as the main Easter egg is a lot of fun. And it's pretty challenging as well. So Shadows definitely deserved the number 4 spot on my list. It's by far one of the best maps ever in Zombies, and probably the best map on disc ever in Zombies as well. Coming in at the number 3 spot is really no surprise that it's going to be, you know, in the top, and that is Dorizondrak. Dorizondrak is a very, very fun map, and it's the best in Black Ops 3, in my opinion, solely because of how cool this map is. Getting the ability to get the bows, the Easter egg is really, really fun. Blowing up the moon, Dempsey killing Dempsey, just the atmosphere of this map was so cool. Having the first boss fight, I mean, this map really set the tone for the rest of Black Ops 3 that it was going to be an amazing year in Zombies, and I really do enjoy it a lot. Coming in at the number 2 spot is going to be Origins. Now, I don't really need to explain why this is one of my favorite maps. The staffs, the 1,000-foot robots, the fog rolling in, just to name a few reasons why I love the map. But in all honesty, the Verkuta steps of the Easter egg are fantastic. Such a cool map. And the cutscene, man, it still mind blows you every freaking time you watch it, because it is so, so interesting. So Origins got the number 2 spot. And coming in at the number 1 spot, this is probably no surprise to any of you guys that actually know me or know my channel, it's Mob of the Dead. It has to be Mob of the Dead, because I literally love that map so much. I talk about it all the time. Whenever I get the opportunity to put some gameplay in a video, I do it, because I love Mob of the Dead so much. It cannot be a better map for me. I love everything about it. The Blunder Gat is so cool. The Golden Spork, the Hell's Retriever, which can be upgraded to the Hell's Redeemer. Doing the Easter egg as fast as possible, because I love speed runs that it pains me to watch anyone else play the map, but still I love Mob of the Dead so much, and it had to be the number 1 spot for me and the best map in Call of Duty Zombies. So anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I understand that you are probably not going to agree with my list, and that is totally fine. I want to know your opinions down in the comment section, so let me know. And, you know, try to be a little nice. You don't have to go disliking the video just because I put Mob of the Dead at number 1 and you think Origins should be number 1 or something like that. I understand that everyone's going to have a different opinion on this list, and this is just my personal opinion of the maps. Thank you guys so much for watching. My name is Greg FPS, the Zombies Extraordinaire, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Peace out.